Hi, it's Nikki here from Happy Hormones for Life. Today I am talking about progesterone, really the power of it and why you need it and how to get more of it. We all know that oestrogen it has a crucial role to play in all phases of a woman's life. However, not much is talked about in terms of its sister hormone, progesterone. This hormone is super, super important. Progesterone's main job is to prepare the womb for a healthy pregnancy, and that's why it gets its name, progestation. But it does so much more than that. It's your calming hormone, it helps you sleep, it reduces anxiety, it balances out too much estrogen. So it works alongside estrogen in a very balanced ratio. So when either hormone strays out of balance, the other one's affected and we can feel symptoms of that. So what does progesterone do? Well, it's a steroid hormone that is essential for healthy reproduction and for a lot of other things that you may not be aware of. Your monthly cycle. Progesterone is released in your luteal phase, the second half of your cycle after ovulation, and it's there to prepare the uterus for implantation. But you know, if your levels are low or you don't ovulate, you can get symptoms of PMS, headaches, heavy painful periods, all that stuff. It's vital for your thyroid. Progesterone helps thyroid hormones get into your cells and work. That's why your temperature goes up slightly at ovulation. So low levels of progesterone can contribute to fatigue, weight gain, feeling cold, hair loss, anxiety, depression, and more, all those symptoms of a low thyroid. It helps with your bones and your muscles. It promotes bone-building cells, osteoblasts. It protects against osteoporosis and promotes new muscle growth as well. It helps with your sleep, so it helps promote the calming hormone GABA, which helps reduce stress and induces a good quality sleep at night. It helps with your mood. It's thought of as nature's antidepressant. Progesterone enhances mood and reduces anxiety. It helps with hot flushes by balancing out estrogen. It helps with brain fog and memory loss. It inhibits androgens in the skin, reducing like breakouts and oily skin, and helps to produce collagen. And it really, its main job is to regulate estrogen. So it can reduce the risk and severity of estrogen-driven conditions like fibroids, PCOS, endometriosis, water retention, fluid retention, bloating, that kind of stuff. So what causes the deficiency in progesterone? Well, obviously perimenopause, because as your eggs start to run out, you may not be ovulating every month, and progesterone only really gets produced when you ovulate, so levels can fall. Stress causes deficiency as well. So when your body's making cortisol to help deal with stress all the time, it sacrifices the production of progesterone, often at a time when we're already low. So stress management is key. And then too high levels of estrogen, if we've got too much estrogen going on, then symptoms of low progesterone can be exacerbated as well. So how do we measure progesterone levels? Well, you can do it manually by taking your temperature. So if you take it during your luteal phase, so from ovulation mid-cycle to the end of your cycle, and if it's lower than it should be, then you may not have enough progesterone going on. But obviously more accurate are lab tests. So we use state-of-the-art urine tests that measure progesterone and its metabolites so that we can see you know, what your levels are and what it's doing in the body as well. Of course, alongside estrogen, which is really important. So how do we increase progesterone naturally? Well, you can do a lot to support your own natural production of progesterone, even after menopause. It's not going to be as effective as actually taking progesterone, but your body needs certain nutrients to produce it. So that's absolutely key. Things like vitamin C, which you can get in fruits and some vegetables, bell peppers, that kind of thing. Your body needs zinc. So that's shellfish, meat, nuts, seeds, things like that. Pumpkin and flax are really important for those, for the zinc levels. Magnesium. So all your nuts and seeds, again, your green leafy veg, your avocado, legumes, beans, dark chocolate is on that list as well with the magnesium, which is good. Vitamin E in things like almonds, sunflower seeds, loads of vegetables. And B6, really important as well. So that's things like fish and meat, walnuts, beans, sweet potatoes, bananas, that kind of thing. And if you're not getting enough of that in your diet, or you have absorption issues, you're definitely going to need to supplement. The next thing you need to do is to manage your stress. We know how much stress has an impact on progesterone. So we want to do that daily switching off, the meditation, the mindfulness, the walking in nature, all of that stuff for a good 15 to 20 minutes a day if you can do. And then you want to try and avoid any hidden stressors that are internal. So things like food sensitivities, alcohol, gut problems, hormone imbalances, nutrient deficiencies that we can all test for as well. And then we want to look at estrogen. So we want to balance our blood sugar to make sure that we are reducing excess insulin, which pushes up estrogen levels. All of these things I'm mentioning, there's blogs on, by the way, you can go and look at these in more detail, but I'm really just looking at the overview. We want to be looking at reducing our refined carbs and sugar, alcohol and processed foods, because that again can upset the blood sugar and increase excess oestrogen. We want to be including phytoestrogens in the diet to balance out those oestrogen levels, so things like organic soy and flax seeds, lentils and chickpeas and things like that. And then we want to be looking at our environmental oestrogens as well, those plastics, those pesticides and those synthetic fragrances that we can really just minimise our exposure to stop those extra foreign oestrogens coming in and tipping out the balance. Supplement wise, you want to be looking at your basic five, which you can go and look at in the website. And really just looking at a quality multivitamin with all those nutrients that I mentioned before, a good magnesium, glycinate or citrate are my favourite forms, they're much more absorbable by the body, a good vitamin C, a good vitamin D3 with K2 if you want to put that in as well, chromium for blood sugar support if that's a problem for you, adrenal support if adrenals are all stressed out, so things like ashwagandha, rhodiola, there's some really nice formulas over on my supplement recommended brand page. Agnus castus vitex is a herb that can really help to stimulate progesterone, but it doesn't work for everyone and it might only have a minimal effect. So if you've tried all this and your levels continue to be low and you've still got symptoms, if you're suffering from poor sleep and or anxiety and you're in the perimenopause, then it's likely to be low progesterone. But you want to be talking to your doctor about maybe natural progesterone replacement, make sure it's body identical or micronized progesterone, not synthetic progestins, which are the ones that are found in combination HRT treatments like combined patch tablets or implants, and in the birth control pill, and in smaller quantities in the Mirena, although it's not so much of an issue there. So I would just say be very careful buying progesterone creams on the internet. Only a few of them have actual progesterone in them as an ingredient. A lot of them are just got yam extract, which isn't going to convert in the body. And they're all unlicensed and unregulated in this country. You know, sorting your hormones out on your own, like DIY hormone treatment, is not something I would recommend. You really ideally need your hormones tested to know what your body needs. But if you can't afford to invest in testing, then do speak to your doctor about trying the micronized progesterone, which is called Utrogestan. It's the only licensed progesterone brand on the NHS called Utrogestan. If you'd like to discuss whether hormone testing would benefit you or you want more information on that, do get in touch. But I hope that's been a little bit enlightening about our lovely hormone progesterone. I'll see you next time.